And just look how happy he is.
What's up guys, Sal here. So smartphones continue to get better year after year. And if we talk about in the last year or so, camera quality in particular has improved dramatically. We have phones that take over 100 megapixel images, that can record 8K videos, can zoom in to 100 times and more. Camera sensors have gotten bigger, phones have periscope zoom cameras now. All of these tech help users take a better picture and better videos. But it comes with a cost. All of these technologies make the camera bump big. Not just big, massive. The Galaxy S20 Ultra and Note 20 Ultra have two of the biggest camera bumps we've ever seen in a smartphone. Especially on the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, it's so big that it kinda scares me to put the phone on its back on my desk. Using a thick case would solve this problem a little bit, but not everyone likes cases. But thankfully, Samsung will address this issue to some degree on the Galaxy S21 Ultra. Samsung made its new smartphone camera sensors official, which promises a smaller camera bump on your future smartphones. They unveiled four sensors that are the successor to the already available camera sensors from Samsung, from 32 megapixel up to 108 megapixels. The pixel size is even smaller here at 0.7 microns compared to 0.8 microns on their current flagships. In fact, Samsung says these sensors are up to 15% smaller than the 0.8 micron pixel sensors we have on the S20 Ultra and Note 20 Ultra with the same resolution and same features, while the height is reduced by up to 10% as well. Now, since the pixel size has been reduced, the camera quality in low light conditions could reduce as well. But to avoid that, Samsung has incorporated its ISOCELL Plus and Smart ISO technologies in these sensors. This will ensure an ample amount of light is captured by these small pixels, resulting in better low-light photos. In fact, Samsung says with this new technology, light sensitivity is increased by up to 12% compared to current-gen ISOCELL Plus technology on the S20 and Note 20 Ultra. So this means not only we are getting a sleek Galaxy S21 lineup next year with reduced size of camera bumps, but the camera quality is also getting better at the same time. Now, another big thing about these camera sensors is that they can record at 120 frames per second at 4K resolution. The Note 20 Ultra can do 120fps at 1080p. 4K at 120fps means the slow motion videos are gonna be really sharp with a good dynamic range. This also means you can film those great slow-mo cinematic videos while keeping the high resolution. Even Apple doesn't provide 4K at 120fps, so it's impressive to see Samsung pull ahead with video recording. Surely this is gonna be one of the highlight camera features of the Galaxy S21 lineup next year. Now there are other camera sensors Samsung made official, as you can see, 64, 48, 32 megapixel, which are intended for affordable flagships or mid-range smartphones. So you can expect the Galaxy S21 and S21 Plus to house one of these sensors. Previous information revealed that Samsung is using two telephoto cameras on the S21 Ultra. One is a 3x zoom, another is more than 5x periscope zoom. So you'd be totally wrong if you thought Samsung wouldn't focus on the camera next year after making it the focal point this year. Anyway, for all the latest updates on the Galaxy S21, please be sure to subscribe. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.